Hey everyone, Gabriel Nassif for ChannelFireball.com. Gabriel Nassif, bonjour, bonjour. And today I'm going to be playing Sulpai Snow, which is a deck I talked a bit about in my last article. I've had time to play a bit with it. It hasn't been super impressive, but I do have a winning record, something like 9-6 in the leagues. Not the greatest win rate, but the deck is functional, and the ninjas have been kind of impressive. I think I posted a list in my last article. I also posted things like Twitter screenshots of lists from another player. I decided not to play Snapcaster Mage, basically. Probably the most notable missing card. But I'll go through the cards real quick. We've got a 4 Fairy Seer, 1/1. When it comes into play, Scry 2. It's a fairy. It works with Spell Stutter Sprite. It works with Wizard's Retort in our sideboard. It's a wizard as well. It obviously gives you something to attack into Ninja Stone on turn 2. It's also a blue card for Force of Negation, and one of the questions I get a lot is why not play Fairy Miscreant, which is a 1/1 flying for 1 that draws you a card when you already have one in play. And I think this card is better. I've had people who play a bunch of Pauper who are used to playing with Fairy Miscreant and who've tried Fairy Seer and said Fairy Seer is much better. Maybe not as effective in this deck because you shuffle, so the scry is not as good. It's probably better in the, like, I don't know, there's still 20 island decks or something, or if everyone plays Brainstorm and Fetchlands, but yeah. So Ferrisser has been pretty good so far. I think you need some 1-drops. You could play the 1/1 Changeling. Couple Spell Pierce, just cheap interaction. And another thing I'm going to be trying today is no Inquisition of Kozlek. I decided I wanted cards that just affect the boards, just creatures or removal or counter spells. I didn't want to trade even 1 mana for a card in their hand and also not have a dead top deck later in the game. Might be a bit ambitious. Inquisition of Kozlek is just a phenomenal magic card and should probably be playing some numbers. But I'm going to try no Inquisition today. For Fatal Push, just obviously a great card in some matchups, terrible in some others, but I think you just have to play some removal, and Fatal Push is by far the best one you can play. Birds, another questionable card. We're basically splashing for birds and Ice Fang Coddle. Might seem a bit light, but both cards have been pretty good. Ice Fang Coddle is incredible, and birds just really, really solid in this deck. So trying still the green version for now. I'll probably try a few different versions, see what I like better, but still on birds. Spell Stutter Sprite, just Jack's of all trade, I guess, does a little bit of everything. It's been pretty solid. It's a card you board out in some matchups or board out on the draw, but pretty solid overall. Ice Fang Cuddle, the reason to splash green. You could play the same deck with no birds, but still splash green for a Cuddle. I mean, I love this card. Is it worth playing? It's not clear. You know, are they actually going to end up being tier 1 decks with Cuddle in them? We'll see. I hope so. Infiltrator. I think it's good. I actually started my first version, I think, was no Infiltrator. It was just a Fallen Shinobi. But I remember a lot of games that I was wishing I had Infiltrator in hand instead of Shinobi, so I just decided to add Infiltrator but keep Shinobi. I think the Shinobi has been pretty impressive too. Force of Negation, I think it's a good card in the deck. Kind of works well with what you're trying to do. Just really solid card right now. You usually have an extra green, an extra blue card you don't super need, whether it's Shinobi because you have two or you don't have the mana, or like kind of a two drop that's kind of redundant. Obviously you can hard cast it later in the game. It exiles, which means bye-bye lootings, etc. Click seems like a no-brainer in these kind of decks, but I could see cutting it, especially if you play four Snapcaster Mage. Snapcaster Mage is kind of a free mana card in this deck, and you don't want too many free mana cards. So yeah. But you know, you clear the way, you see what they have. It's not a flash creature for Shinobi, etc. Plague Engineer main deck is might be questionable. I just want to play with the card a bunch. I've been pretty impressed. It's just a really solid card right now. Lots of one toughness decks. The Devoted Druid deck is popular. Infect is popular. People are playing Rabble Masters and Warboss, so that can help you there too. You know, it's one-sided, so you can name humans and not kill your own stuff, or wizards and not kill your own creatures. It's also good after sideboard against the Hogak deck. When you have Leyline, you play Engineer and you kind of get rid of the little stuff flying around. It's not a bad card. Fallen Shinobi card has been definitely playable. I don't know how good. I think it's been good. The effect is not always backbreaking, but it also just hits really hard. And just the fact to bounce a Coddle to your hand and get to replay it for value, spell, stutter, sprite, that's more true for the Infiltrator, because by the time you're putting the Shinobi in play and hitting for five, you're usually doing okay. The synergy is really, really nice. I've definitely had games where it was relevant for me to some grindy games to bounce spell, stutter, sprite, or Coddle was Infiltrator and get my value. And then Cryptic Command, a card I just added. Probably too good not to play at least one or two copies. Also gives you odds against stuff like Ensnaring Bridge and stuff, which is nice. Just a solid card, so I'm going to try it out. And then the sideboard is pretty straightforward. Lots of graveyard hate, four Leyline, and three Ravenous Traps. There's a small chance, tiny chance, you don't want Leyline and you just want old traps and surgicals and Tormod Script. Maybe not in this version specifically, but typically in these blue decks where you play Serum Vision and Opt and you see a lot of cards, you might just want the ones you can draw into and not the ones you need to have in your opening hand. Wizard's Retort, just overall, I think this card might be better than Mana Leak or Disdainful Stroke. It's a bit hard on the mana, but counters everything, comes in against big mana control, counters something like a Lyra, Primeval Titan. People have been playing Ponza with like Storm Rip Dragon and Thunder Mahogkite, who knows, just against combo decks, you want more counterspell. Thoughtseize, kind of same deal, big mana, controlled combo. Tracker is mostly for control. The Force Plague Engineer, because I think there's matchups where you just want four humans, all the creature decks, infect. Dismember, another spot removal. I mean, you could argue you could play one in the main deck too. And another Cryptic Command, kind of same deal, big mana decks, Tron, Scapeshift, etc. Just versatile card. Maybe even bring it against something like humans. I'm not too sure. And I guess I didn't do the mana. Mana is pretty straightforward. Some basic snow covered basic lands, dual lands, fetch lands, etc. A couple of sanctums. Last thing, you know, it's not the end of the world if you played Coddle and you don't have the free snow permanence right away, even if it's later in the game. Still decent. So when you build your decks with Coddle in them, something to keep in mind. It's not if you don't need to, don't go crazy with cards like Astrolabe or don't go too far out of your way, basically. Don't mess up your mana base too much. Play kind of the mana base you would probably regularly play, maybe one extra basic or something, and just let it get death touch naturally. Anyways, yeah, that's it for the deck, and I'll jump into the action. All right, round one, we are on the draw, and a perfectly fine hand. Looks like we're getting hit by some kind of maybe Inquisition, Stomping Ground. Search for Tomorrow, okay. Not played against that deck in a little while. Let's see, blue, force, blue, black. I don't think it matters too much. I'm gonna go under 18 anyways against Scape Shift, and that's the kind of relevant number here. That looks really strong. I can slow them down a lot. I might even just force really any ram spell. Deck definitely doesn't deal. It's kind of interesting. Birds, then I can Ninja Infiltrator, save Ice Fang for, or I can play Ice Fang Coddle, then potentially have to force away Shinobi. Play Ice Fang Coddle. If they have a spot removal, something like a Bolt, and I play Bird over Coddle, it's gonna feel kind of bad. I think I'm not gonna mess around too much and just get my watery grave. Oh, that's search resolve. Maybe I'll force some other ramp spell down the line. They have acid moss in their deck. The card's kind of scary. It's three counters and they have four cards in hand. Let's see, I'm gonna start by getting Breeding Pool, drawing my card with Coddle. Hopefully I draw some kind of extra blue card. That'd be the dream. It's a pretty good extra blue card though. Counter Colony Heart, or do I counter their next ram spell? Also, what do I get rid of? Maybe I just skip the Infiltrator step and just try to go straight for Shinobi. Does let me go that plus Bird. This is close. Do I get rid of Click or do I get rid of Infiltrator? Or do I get rid of nothing? It's kind of interesting. Free counters. Well, I guess I'll let them have it. Kind of giving away that I have Force of Negation here. I'm just going to save my Force for their next ramp spell. That's the reasoning here. All right, I drew a land, so maybe now I can just click into Fallen Shinobi. I think I like that. No, I wish I had Forced. Maybe that was a play all along, Forced with Infiltrator. Because they don't... They don't even need much, they just need like a fetch land here and I'm in trouble. They have the fetch land, they also have the Titan and another. Oof, let's take Titan. Yeah, so it looks like I was somewhat screwed regardless, maybe not though. Oh, this is gonna be tricky. So they have the lethal scape shift already. Now they're just gonna trigger that of that. I mean, I feel like I just have to Force that and hope I draw something good. Yeah, man. This seems like a tough matchup. I had a good draw too. I had Pierce into Coddle into Click, back up Force into Shinobi, and so it didn't matter. They were on the play and they had a close to perfect hand, to be fair, so. Maybe I shouldn't feel too bad about it. That's a weird play. I guess it's fine. Wait, don't they lose a... Didn't they lose a bunch of damage there? Alright, I mean, they have scape shift, right? Let's stop wasting everyone's time. Kitty man. Alright, I expect sideboard games to be a bit easier. Hard counter is gonna go a very, very long way. Not a bunch of really bad cards in the main. I even get one more card. What's the least terrible card against them? This random creature.
Fatal Push.
Fatal Push, Dismember. Plague Engineer. I don't even have a blue card, like random blue card would be better than any of that. Let's see. I guess I'll just do Engineer. They might bring in their own tracker. I should probably just have a Dismember or Fatal Push. Kind of a risky keep. I could get Watery Grave turn one into Fairy Seer. Hope to hit a land. Or I could go turn one bird. Doesn't have a ton of disruption, it's a bit clunky. think I'm actually gonna mulligan that. Same hand but worse. That sucks. Alright. So I don't fetch on turn one, I can go turn two, dodge C's bird. I can just guess bird on turn one. I mean, fairy seer on turn one. I'll cast bird. Basically same as the first one, but much worse. Not much worse, but a bit worse. Okay. I might just click myself. Their hand's gonna be like pretty redundant and stuff. I'm gonna click my my fairy seer away. Or not. Yeah, forgot about that card. As this card is a must counter. Because if I don't counter that, then they don't even need to resolve anything to win. They just need to draw a Valakut. I think it's better to just Thoughtseize and play Fairy Seer and hit them with Infiltrator next turn. Bolt, Hour of Promise, Primeval Titan. I'll contribute Hour of Promise. Deal with a Titan in a turn or two. So they have bolts. One of my dudes gonna die. It's gonna be. I guess I'll top. Don't ask me why I didn't top the land on top. I don't think it's going to make a difference, though. Alright, they do have the bolt. So they're going to bolt, take a turn. Then they can cast Titan, so I need to click them. I guess I just attack and say go. And click them at the end of their turn. This version, I'm always impressed by Kong and Hour of Promise, but maybe that's because I play, maybe that's because I usually play control decks, more fair decks, and these cards maybe are not good against other decks, but I've always been, as a blue-white player, Colony is kind of a nightmare. Hour of Promise is a must counter, basically. It's like, it's almost like a mini Primeval Titan. Alright. Have to pray now. Bounce the Vendilion click. Nothing great I can hit in this matchup. 8 Hour of Promise. I guess Ram spells are like pretty decent. I just held them. I traded off 2 lands from the top. I guess they're gonna shuffle anyways. No shuffling, I guess, in case they top deck Valakut. I didn't draw it. So I see huge for me. If I exile enough mountains, I guess, they might not be able to kill me. Alright, they need double top deck. I did not think I was gonna win this game. Not like. Alright, looks like they didn't draw anything good. Yeah, first couple turns of the game. I guess I was supposed to play Fairy Seer that one turn. I was like being kind of. Dismember. I was being kind of optimistic, I guess, thinking I would not have to use my Wizard's Retort on turn two. Definitely a matchup where Inquisition would be good. Very curious to see how much I miss Inquisition, but it was kind of a bit awkward for me and just the way the games were playing out. I guess this is a lot of lands. Is a bit better. I just don't think I can go down to 5. I guess it's not better. I guess the extra infiltrator is gonna go to 4. Yeah, this is probably a keep with this cry. I need to have a creature in top 3 cards basically. Ah, no ram spells. I guess I don't treat on the draw land. I was wondering if I should fin the deck or not. Oh no, the one basic swamp. The one card in my entire deck that doesn't cast Ice Fang at all. Feels bad. What's the play here? Force that was Ice Fang maybe? Am I gonna ever play a second infiltrator in this game? Sprite doesn't, no, never mind, I can't do Sprite, I'm dumb. Infiltrator or Ice Fang? I guess Ice Fang. It might kill my first infiltrator with a bolt. Pretty interesting. Yeah, just play around bold here. They have Bolt, they have Omen. And they have Valakut in play. Yeah, I don't know how I mean, I kind of have to take the Omen. Kind of screwed regardless. I need them to do like search for tomorrow or something. Something I can counter with Spell Pierce somehow. Yeah. It's not great. Not great. Yeah. Looks like GG. I bought him to land too, but obviously I had to. Kind of want to scoop. Do not believe I can win this game. That's 12 damage right there. Alright, good games. Well, that's not the greatest start. Yeah, doesn't seem like a great matchup. Classic Valakut. Alright. Round two, we won the Tyrell this time. Seems like a really good hand. See, I need more lands, kind of. I think I'm gonna bottom version top overgrown tomb. They have a turn one removal for fairies here. I guess this is gonna be rough. Flooded Strand, main phase. Is that a Serum Visions, maybe? Alright. I like my chances. What are we gonna fetch? Should I just get basic swamp? Probably not. Oh, never mind. I have overgrown tomb. Another Flooded Strand, another Serum Visions. Playing their land. Before Serum Visions. All right. Let's see. I'll fetch basic Allen, I guess. Don't want to fetch too many basics against the Field of Ruin deck, but the Field of Ruin slash Fast to Exile deck. Never mind, they're just mono blue. Seems good. Land seems good too, actually. Maybe I can shuffle the land away, I'll see what happens. Okay, they are blue-red, not just mono-blue. Makes sense. Vendilion click. Well, can't do anything about it, right? They have to take Fallen Shinobi, I'm assuming. But that means they get hit by Double Infiltrator. Alright, I guess I'm gonna shuffle first. Tag with everyone. They got to block a Shinobi. This click was pretty strong for them. I'm gonna bounce the Coddle. Oh yeah, I still get to draw two cards of the one. Duh. A discard? I'll take it. Good problem to have right now. Ooh, Mismatch Islands. And that card's not too scary. Ice Fang Coddle is actually pretty sweet against it. Sinkhole, my dude. I don't even think I want to Spell Pierce that. I think I'm perfectly fine. I'm just gonna beat them down with my flyers, and if they ever flip thing in the ice, I get to recast all my calls at instant speed. I guess just have to make sure I have maybe three other snow permanents. Let's see. Just click them. I could click them now even, so I don't get remanded. Maybe I'll do that. Means I don't have Cryptic Command up though, but I think that's fine given that I'll have seen their hand. Snap and Cryptic. Come on, I'd let them have both. Neither of these cards do anything right now. Snap, I can straight up counter with Spell Stutter Sprite. No way to trigger our thing in the ice. Have to be a bit wary of Blood Moon in game 2. Alright, I'm not gonna just jam Coddle into a Cryptic Command here when I have Spell Pierce. I think they know about the Spell Pierce. Sure, if it makes a big difference, they probably still have to. Alright, just gonna keep all the mana up in case they get to flip thing in the ice. Archmage Charm. Should I just straight up counter that? I kind of get owned, I feel, if... I think I just let them draw, let them flip thing in the ice. If I cryptic that and they have remand, I probably still end up winning the game, but it's kind of awkward. Debating whether I should play Spell Stutter Sprites. That makes it easy. Actually, I misplayed, right? I'm supposed to wait for the trigger to be on the stack. Doesn't matter because I have cryptic command, but... That was a tiny bit loose. So it's not a trigger that debounces, it like triggers when it flips. It's not like when you remove or when you cast your force spell or whatever, so you just bounce it or kill it in response, just doesn't bounce anything. Let's see. Nice tricky sideboard in matchup where wait, he scooped? Alright, looks like they just scooped. Looks like they were just done. So, we're done with round two as well. I was gonna say, it's always kind of tricky to sideboard in a matchup where a deck that has very few creatures, but also really annoying ones. Not sure how many fatal pushes I would have kept. Alright, round three. The Tailor Me kept 7 on the play. And I have somewhat of a sketchy hand. All right, I'll keep, I guess. I don't feel like my deck mulligan especially well. Sure, you can make up for the cards with Genius and Infiltrator, but... Then you still have to have the other cards in the late game. Well, it looks like it might not matter if we're playing against the Hogak Menace. Force of Negation is what I was looking for. Also, like, every mulligan also makes Force of Negation worse. Turn one, a bridge, and a Ventrine in the yard. They're playing the version with the dredgers. Some versions play a couple dredgers, some versions play a few more dredgers and some Kasarati Ukrainians. Triple looting. Alright. I'm just gonna say good. Do you have cards that creatures that they actually want to cast here, or? Because they're bringing back all these dredgers. I'm not sure what they have in hand. Can you have a Gravecrawler in the graveyard? Maybe I'll just counter the supplier and that'll be enough to like disrupt their entire draw. I mean, I don't think I can win in a million years, but it would be kind of hilarious if they're only on that supplier. So let's get Sigur again in case they draw another supplier or they flash. They probably want to flashback looting here. Altar of Dementia. Why are they not just casting their dudes? What does that do for them? Not crazy, they have Imp and Thug in hand. Alright, I'll let it resolve, I guess. Or are they not just casting an Imp there? Cast a name, cast a thug next turn. It's a really weird game. Definitely no, and don't want that either. Gotta counter that. If I let them get two creatures in play, they can bring back Hogak. Bad draw. I'm going to bounce a sprite. I can't really cast the other one anyways. Alright. Looks like we might end up losing anyways. I really needed a land there, and I would have probably won the game. Okay, they just have a nymph. So that's not too bad for me. They're not quite dead on board, but they're probably not gonna block Infiltrator. So if I draw a land, I'll probably kill them. Because they'll probably block one of the 1/1s. Oh, never mind, I'm dumb. I'm so dumb. That's why I was maybe supposed to actually counter Altar. Well, not like there's anything I could have done about it. Can they actually go off here, though? Oh, yeah, of course they can. Cast Hogak. Bring back free Vengevine. Yeah, I was one land away from from probably winning this game. I mean, I was one away from winning this game somehow. I don't think that's very representative of how this game should go. I have the feeling they might have messed up too their first few turns. Maybe they just had a really awkward hand. I have the feeling they might have gotten greedy with their dredging. Plague Engineer, yes. Thought Seize, yes. How's I boarding in this matchup? Fatal push teams. Especially bad. Probably having the blue cards doesn't hurt too much. Was I boarding out Shinobi? Was I boarding out Click? Tracker seems a bit slow. I need the expensive stuff. I played that matchup a few times. I'm trying to remember what I was boarding out. I didn't take a good look at what mana they had. I could board out all the expensive stuff. Could board out Fairy Seer, maybe. All right, I'll keep. Seems good. Could just board out maybe the birds if I'm boarding out a bunch of 4 mana cards anyways. So what's the deal here? Should I hit them right away or should I keep Wizard's Retort up? I feel like I should probably just keep Wizard's Retort up. They might even just hard cast a Stinkwit Imp and I'd be okay countering that. Pretty hard to lose. Was Ley Line in play? This is basically one red draw, two cards for them right now, but I still don't think I should counter it. I should just see if my counter spells for a card that actually do something. Looks like I'm going to be able to keep two blue up most of the game. The only card I really care about right now is to get a hard cast of Ventrine next turn. But yeah. Maybe I should start getting snow permanents. Having said that, in case I need my Coddle to have Death Touch. Like an Overgrown Tomb. I've actually almost never seen anyone cast Ventrine enough to Overgrown Tomb. Let's see if they do it this game. I mean, it's fine, it's not even that big of a deal. Human Warrior. The 100. Never mind, just even scoop here. Nope. Not quite yet. Maybe they could have a second Ventrine. Might have to use a counterspell there. The backup to the line. Disclaimer, I don't know how good Ravenous Trap is. I actually played a league with the deck where I had a Hallowed Fountain in the main deck and four Rest in Peace on top of the four ley lines in my sideboard. And in five rounds, I think I ended up going 3-2, and in five rounds I didn't play against a single graveyard deck. It was, I lost to Blue-White Control, they were playing Mentor main deck. I lost to Mono-Red Prison, and then I beat a bunch of, I think I beat Infect, I beat Devoted Company, and Death Shadow. Engineer was a house in all the matchups I won. I've just been really impressed by Engineer. I just really like the card. I used to play Engineer at Plague back in the day, usually naming goblins. I mean, if they have zero cards in here, I was gonna say if they have another Ventrine. Never know. So yeah, not sure how effective Ravenous Trap is. I'm guessing if I have a decent draw plus a Ravenous Trap. Okay, whatever that is, gonna get countered. Sure, why not? Just wanna kill them. Yeah, I feel like maybe my deck's a bit, especially since they actually have like Stinkweed Imps and they have cards to block Infiltrator. Maybe I need to sideboard a bit differently. Let's see. Fatal push. Basically, you've got to assume you're not keeping a hand without leyline or trap. So you shouldn't be like, all right, what if I don't have one of these cards? And you should assume you're going to have one of these cards in hand and sideboard accordingly, I guess. Clicks blocks Venchline. Tracker can be good in these sideboard games too, a bit grindier with leyline. They have Nature's Claim. Maybe the games go a bit longer. But I think I have to keep in Dotties and Spell Pierce. Maybe Spell Pierce gets much worse on the draw. It does counter Nature's Claim though. But if I have Leyline, they're probably gonna Nature's Claim on their turn one. They might even be boarding out Altar. I don't know what they board out in these matchups. Spell Pierce also a blue card for Force of Negation. I wouldn't hate having a few more blue cards, I guess. I guess I'll just board out the birds. And I'll do couple click. Wizard's Retort. Maybe I'll do the tracker. Yeah, honestly, not too sure. It's a lot of free mana cards. Yeah, I rely a bit too heavily on Engineer. Alright, hand does nothing and doesn't have a hate card in it. Hand's terrible and sure. They didn't see Ravenous Trap, so I guess I just let them have it, right? And I guess I have to trap them now. I mean, it might be good if I can slow them down a bit. Not the greatest mail for them. I guess they mailed a thug. Yeah, no, that's gonna be game. Hogex coming for me. Yeah, maybe I should have waited on trap. Maybe I needed to push it a bit. I don't have a ton of experience playing with that card. We're playing in dead deck yet. All right, so they just get to cast Hogek now. Ravenous Trap seemed quite good though. It's kind of like a one mana or one card for some negation for Faithless Looting, which is nice. Alright, I mean, game's not technically over. I do have the 2-2 Death Touch in my deck. If I draw it, I could name maybe Zombie. You know what? Maybe it was Ravenous Trap in the deck. You also keep Fatal Push. This way you can just push their supplier. You don't care as much. Should I start getting basic, I should start getting Snowlands for Icewing Coddle. I don't think Icewing Coddle is going to cut it anyways. Oof. All right. How do we win this game? I think I'm drawing dead. Take 11. Yeah. All right, GG's. Always feel somewhat close. Kind of one ley line away. It's kind of funny, Ravenous Trap would have actually been better than Leyline this game, but, yeah, pretty interesting. Let's see, I think I like the way I sideboarded for the most part. Maybe I'm supposed to keep in Burge just because getting to 4 mana for Leyline can be relevant sometimes. It sounds kind of slow though. Alright, we'll see if we can do a bit better in the last couple of rounds. Alright, a ride back for round 4. And looks good. We've had fairly close matches so far. I guess the games against the third game against Hogak was fairly one-sided on the Mulligan to 5, but the deck, I feel like the deck has legs, and I've been somewhat impressed with the Fallen Shinobi, but might be a tiny bit too clunky. You kind of need the lands, the one drop, even though you don't necessarily need a one drop. You're super weak to some cards. I played against a Lavadart, a version of Moderate Phoenix was Lavadart over Gutshot. That was a straight up nightmare. And I think Lavadart should be kind of stock from now on. I don't know. I was really impressed by Lavadart. That kind of draw might be somewhat complicated to beat for me as well. We'll see. One of the big questions is whether to play green or not. Icewing Coddle is just completely absurd, but it's unclear if it's worth it despite everything. Even Bird has been good. I think I'd just try probably try blue-black version, or there's also a version I posted in my article, I think, that's a bit more consistent, maybe, that plays 4-out, 4-snapcaster mage. I haven't tried the 4-snapcaster mage version yet, but I might just have to. It might just be, like, too good of a card, too consistent, etc., to not play. We have a problem here. What's the plan? Let's see. So I think the plan is just Fallen Shinobi and hope to get really lucky at the top of their deck. Goblin in the meantime. These Ponza decks have been my nemesis. Red green, doesn't really matter what free drop, what four drop, what five drop they play. I've been losing to these decks a lot with blue light control specifically. I guess Plague Engineer would have been a nice draw. Alright. Birds. Bird stomping around. Alright, that's not gonna do it. Pretty sure I'm just dead on board. Alright, Plague Engineer seems good. Dismember seems good. They probably have Blood Moon, but I'm gonna be on the play. Force of Negation. I think I might want just Thoughtseize. Thoughtseize the creature removal. Bit worried about Blood Moon. Cryptic Command seems hard to cast. Wizard's Retort seems maybe a bit expensive. Maybe just Falpius if I'm worried about Blood Moon. The Spellbearer's Force of Negation is kind of a cool combo in some ways, because if they cast their spell during their turn, you get to counter it for free. If they wait till your turn to make you tap mana on your turn or play around Force of Negation, then sometimes you get to Spell Pierce. Felt like it's definitely come up, and the synergy between the two was kind of nice. Spell Slaughter Strike is another card that can be a bit underwhelming probably in some matchups. I could see cutting... I'll cut a couple Sprite. I do like one Force of Negation, two Spell Pierce. All right, fighting to avoid the one free drop. But I'm probably a bit fast here. This is a bit greedy. I should probably just go maybe Overgrown Tomb turn one and then get basic Hollands with Vista. Should be okay though. Sprawl. Let's see. What you got? Ooh, Arbor Elf. And Rattle Dad. And Vault Raid. I could just take Rattle Dad and then bait them into a Arbor Elf. I don't know if I'm gonna have to play this member next turn. I'll do that. This way if I draw a land, I can play Fallen Shinobi. So they have potentially Bloodbraid Elf next turn. What does Stormrip Dragon do already? Or Thundermaw? Whenever Elka enters a battlefield, it deals 1 damage to each creature with flying your opponent controls. Tap those creatures. That's an interesting one. It's when it enters the battlefield. Jesus Christ. Well then. Alright, that was a really good draw. Oh, I played my land like an idiot. Still not used to it. I think it's gonna be okay regardless. I see, don't want to play your land there in case you hit Blood Moon. Does Blood Moon do anything for me? Somehow Blood Moon screws them? Not really. Alright. Alright, does. And Thundermaw Hellkite too. Jesus Christ. So, Wizard's Retort? So, Cryptic Commands? Cryptic Commands so bad against Blood Moon. Not even sure they should have Blood Moon on the draw against the Birds of Paradise draw. Force of Negation, Spellstutter Sprite on the draw seems pretty atrocious. Gonna do Wither's Retort. I could go Cryptic Command. I could be on the not letting resolve Blood Moon plan and have Cryptic Command to get value. I think Tracker might be a bit slow on the draw. Definitely want all these cards. How realistic is Cryptic Command? I don't think it's super reasonable. That's gonna do all the spell pierce, even though they don't have a ton of spells. It's mostly creatures, that's my problem, but Blood Moon's pretty big deal, and it's not like Cryptic's, I mean, Cryptic can, obviously Cryptic's okay if I ever get to cast. If you ever get to hard cast or cast a Cryptic Command in this matchup, you're probably in good shape, but you have to get to the point where you're casting it. Which is the tricky part. I mean, they probably have a few planeswalkers. They probably, maybe not, they have Bloodbraid. They should have a few non-creature spells besides. I'm gonna keep that hand. I think it's good enough. Unfortunately, it's Sprawl and not Elf. I will play Tricky. I really don't want to get Basic Swamp. All right, actually, I think we're gonna do that. All right, I'm just gonna play Delta Sego. This way, if they have a dude, I had to shoot it with a Fatal Push. Did I play around Blood Moon here? I don't think so. I think it's too important for me to get that that Fairy Seer in play. And I don't have that many green cards in my deck anyways, so if I'm just stuck with blue, blue, black for the rest of the game. I think I should be okay. It's only birds and ice, thank God. I'll Yeah, I have a fairy seer. You have I have two lands and a fairy seer. You have five mana and a bloodbraid elf. I like my chances. What should I name here? Elf, dragon, something else. Yes, just elf. Dragon. Elf doesn't accomplish much. What could I name? I guess goblin, I'm dumb. Never mind. Eh. I'll just name goblin. I might have to block anyways. Inferno Titan? Oh my god. Oh, I can't be dead card in a million years. Yeah. These ram decks, these big mana decks, I'm not really well equipped to deal with them. And I have like Spell Stutter Sprite, all these cards, these like the little incremental card advantage and stuff. I'm not really equipped to deal with 6 mana cards and definitely a weakness. This deck kind of wants to play against the broken decks in some ways. But also not Hogak, so like Infect or Devoted Druid or he's probably Storm. I'd do pretty well. All that stuff. I mean, I got a game mostly when I was on the play or when I had a good draw. I got the game. Being on the play is just super huge with a deck like that. But I'm gonna play the last match. Alright, last round. Won the draw, pretty solid hand. Yeah, it's kind of unfortunate. It's my first that's not true. I think the first league I played was the deck I went 2-3. Then I had the league where I went 4-1, was one game away from a 5-0. Then I went 3-2, and this is a second losing league. Not that league records are like super, super relevant always, but the deck feels tiny, tiny, tiny bit off. So maybe go with Snapcaster Mage. What are we playing against? Watergrave, Brutality, Field of Ruin. Huh. No clue. No clue, but I'll definitely be fetching for there might be some kind of Esper deck too. Definitely be fetching for some non-basics. Could be Grixis. Snow-covered island. Oh, they're playing Mail. Mail, Mail, Mail. I'm gonna fetch now before they mail my breeding pool. Haven't played against Mail as that deck yet. Feel like it might be a fine matchup. Play Collective Brutality and Meld, it seems kind of loose. I'm not a big fan of Collective Brutality. It's good when you're playing Lingering Souls or some other synergy. It's an okay sideboard against Burn even with no synergies. And does it open and have Archive Trap? Did they just drew now? Or what's the deal? I guess they have Surgical, never mind. They're trying to figure out what to Surgical. That's what I wanted to fetch in response to, just... They're going for Force of Negation, a fair target. They're gonna break. So I'm in pretty good shape. I get to click them. Play my fetch while I can. Obviously I should, being a bit lazy here, I should double check that I have a target left. Seems pretty unlikely to just mill all my lands. Wow, okay. It's kind of beating. Well, I guess it's good and bad, right? I'm not gonna complain that they have all lands. I have to play Clegg though, and I think I have to play it right away. It's just, I need a count of a clock. And I'm just gonna bounce Coddle here. Click effect's not very good. We know they have nothing in hand, and it's like just a faster clock. It's also a second, keeping my first fairy in play in case they draw a 2-mana spell. So, fairly straightforward play. Looks like they might have drawn Archive Trap, or they're just trying to manage for me, maybe? Oh, I guess I only have one forest in my, Alright, that was maybe me tapping my mana poorly. Kinda wanna keep Sprite up anyways. I wanna limit their outs as much as I can. So Sheldock Isle is... The library has 20 or fewer cards in it. Don't want to counter that, it's a cantrip. Alright, I'll let them draw one card. Let's cry before I drop the Infiltrator. One, two, three, four, five. I might actually keep that fairy. I can even counter Archive Trap. What are they at? 11? Never mind, I'm done. I mean, I guess it doesn't matter what I keep. They got rid of my Force of Negations. I have not a ton of relevant cards anyways. I'm just worried about it as something like an Ensnaring Bridge. Pretty cool, upside of this build is that I've actually beaten Ensnaring Bridge by attacking with Bird and putting Fallen Shinobis into play. Obviously you have to get them low because it's hard to do that trick multiple times. Alright, I'm assuming I'm just supposed to counter that. I've also lost to Ensnaring Bridge with this deck. Was a version where I didn't even have Cryptic Command. I had zero ways to get rid of a bridge once it was in play. All right. Ravenous Trap, no. Leyline of the Void, no. Dismember should be a yes to have these O2s. Plague Engineer is actually bad in this matchup. Counterspell's coming. Thoughtseize come in. Tracker might come in. Seems unlikely. Oh, Cryptic Commands comes in. Let's see. I need all these cards. I want all these cards. I want all these cards as well. Did I just board out Shinobi? I'm not gonna hit... I could hit Surgical Extractions. I could hit their mill spell and mill them. That seems unlikely. I'm gonna mill them before I just kill them with Shinobi. Tracker's probably a bit slow. I can board out a land too. Matchup that doesn't kill your creature. I think boarding out land is okay. Not a big fan of that though. Alright, this looks good. Hands tiny bit slow. I even have two sources of non-blue for Cryptic Command. Kind of want a mulligan. I don't have a removal spell for a crab. They're on to five. Did not notice that. Man, the crab is just one of their best cards. I don't think I can keep that on top though. No need to search. I'm gonna wait my second turn to search to be able to maybe counter an archive trap. Miss Maricorb. That card is usually a beating. Especially in my deck where I don't have high power creatures, so I don't necessarily kill them very fast. There's like a lot of untapping going on, so. I mean, Arb is just. You should almost always counter that card unless. It's just one of their better engines. Alright, I'm gonna fetch on my turn. Let's get ourselves Watery Grave. This way the Tub Deck Archive Trap. They can't mail me. Here's the crab. Pretty scary. Obviously when they mulligan to five, it's they're kind of like a burn deck. They kind of need critical mass, so. I've never played mill. I'm assuming it's a deck that doesn't mulligan very well. Alright, same deal. I'm gonna keep searching while I can. Get an Overgrown Tomb, keep all my basics in the deck. And I guess might as well main phase that. Keep Black up in case I draw Thoughtseize. Not really care about casting birds with this hand. Rather keep Fatal Push Thoughtseize up. Don't have the fastest clock. But we'd have more permanents and more cards in hand than them. Alright. Well, at least that was fast. Might have been my fastest leg for Channel Fireball. Maybe one time I made a leg with like Scourge of Drazi and that was faster, but yeah, that was the league. Let's take a look at the deck list, and it'd be a good time to remind you to follow the channel, channelfireball.com, if you haven't done so yet. Also, if you ever need singles, any magic product, channelfireball.com is the place to go. if you are interested in not only videos but also articles written by some of the best players in the world, like Paulo Vitor, Adamo De Rosa, Reed Duke, Andrew Amiguchi, lots of other really good writers. You can check out ChannelFireball.com. And yeah, hope you enjoyed the video. I'm gonna take a quick look at the deck list. This is the deck I played. So we struggled against the fair kind of decks, the big mana decks. So more counter spells is always an option. Just turning the deck into, you could play four out, four Snapcaster, be more consistent, then you could play more, counter spells. You have Snapcaster gives you access to your Disdainful Strokes multiple times, or your Wizard's Retort. So definitely a version of the deck. You could also cut the green. Let's see what I have here. That's what I was thinking of when I was thinking blue-black. Still doesn't have the whole Snapcaster Cryptic Command, but maybe it should. Changing Outcast is an interesting card for Ninja strategies. It is unblockable, so it'll allow you to ninjutsu your creatures into play, even though flying is almost always like unblockable. Very few flying blockers. It's also a ninja, meaning that later in the game, if you connect with it and you have Infiltrator in play, you get to draw a card. Not sure how relevant that is. The green Ice Fang Caudal is just such a great card. Lots of decks just splashing for it. I was playing a blue-white control splashing for it. But if I had to play something in the same vein, I'm honestly not too sure what I would change, because it seems like birds should be really good against the fairy decks. I think a little turn one bird should be good. The whole fairy seer spell stutter sprite, I guess, can be a bit underwhelming. Plague Engineer, I think the card's amazing, but it didn't line up very well against. Doesn't line up very well against dragons and Inferno Titans. So there's definitely something to be said about playing Plague Engineer. Fallen Shinobi can be a bit slow. I showed you the version, I think, that had four Cryptic Commands, no Fallen Shinobi. I've been pretty impressed with Fallen Shinobi. I feel like for four mana, I've been happier with Fallen Shinobi than I would have been with Cryptic Command, but the whole Snapcaster out thing plays out very differently. You have more value, you're a bit more control-ish, not as all-in on the combo, even though the version did also play Fairy Seer. So I feel like there's something to it. Maybe not go too hard on the one drops. It's not a big deal if you don't get Infiltrator and play on turn two. Like, if you go like an Inquisition, a Spell Pierce, an Ice Fang, and then turn three, turn four, you get Infiltrator, and you start grinding them out, and you draw more counter spells and disruption. Then you hit with Shinobi. Maybe I feel like the deck is a bit flawed, as in it's kind of hard to. You don't have everything you need. You don't have quite the power level you need to make the get playable. Fairy Seer is. This is not the greatest Magic card, so it might be missing that good one drop. Maybe Hierarch is good in this deck. Maybe a version with four birds for Hierarch. Maybe a four color version was white, if you're gonna play birds and Hierarch. But then that's a lot of mana sources, and you really need the heavy hitters. And typically these birds Hierarch decks have problems where you're gonna flood sometime, and then. When they kill your birds and you kept a land light hand, you're gonna get mana screwed, so not too sure. Sideboard was okay, I guess. We still lost to Hogak. We still lost one of the sideboard games to Hogak, despite our 7 hate cards. But hope you enjoyed the league, and I'll see you next time. Take care, everyone.